This is a podcast 75 years in the making. It's a podcast about history.
Bring pork chops and applesauce.
It's a podcast about family.
The love is deep for her.
But most importantly, it's a podcast about you.
Sounds kind of weird.
It's season 3 of the official Holiday World Podcast, chronicling our 75th year of family fun.
Friends, welcome back to season 3 of the official Holiday World Podcast. This is season 3, episode 20, the one with stamps. Today is Thursday, October 7th for us, but we expect to release this episode October 18th. Yes, I have entitled it the one with stamps because I, we've got some feedback, we've got some holidays, and a loose theme for the rest of it.
So October 18th, we're almost closed then.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Getting close.
We're getting there.
So welcome back, Matt E.
Yes. Thank you.
Hello. I really wanted it to just end with yes.
You can edit that out then, Steven. Just yes.
Oh, he's keeping it.
Fourth generation owner, Lauren Crosby.
Ahoy!
Always trying to outdo me.
I wanted something different.
Media relations manager, Sabrina.
Hello.
That's all I get.
We're getting interesting. Of the Santa Claus Museum and Village, Nell.
I'm here.
Hey, Nell.
Hi.
That's a very happy I'm here.
I know.
Shocking today.
And we have Chief Operating Officer Matt B.
Heyo.
Very nice.
It's a little Andy from The Office.
I feel like it's been a while since we've recorded and you can hear it. Well, welcome back, guys.
Buckle up, everyone.
We're
this
in a
is
place.
Going to be an interesting
one. We're in rare form.
No, you would think that this is like 2 a.m., but it's not.
It's
about 2 p.m.
Josh is losing it over there.
We're coming in with something.
Yeah. Lots of caffeine.
Yeah. I feel like this is fitting. So today's episode theme is very loose, frankly, because we've covered a lot of happy Halloween weekends recently. Thank you, Sabrina, for she did some interviews on the spot to cover an episode. Thank goodness.
And bless Steven for cobbling that together because
cobbling.
That was... Yes.
I think that's the word for it.
I like
we hand him
word.
Like snippets nice. Of things and yep. he makes it look like it's a thing.
At least
maybe
based upon
or sound
yes.
like
based upon what I helped record, yes, I would imagine yeah. that it needed to be.
There's a
cobbled.
Lot of
I feel like our portion could have almost been a musical and bless you for like putting that together. I won't use cobble again.
I like that word.
I like cobble.
Something. Stitching, quilting,
I know,
what are
I was
some
like,
other
quilted?
Synonyms here?
I literally was thinking quilted too. Yeah.
Adhering nice. those together. It was like, but you and I like sang the whole time. Like, just, yeah.
Note to self, don't listen to that.
Yeah, it was a good one.
Nell's face right now.
You all sang the whole time?
Kind of.
We locked ourselves in Sabrina's office.
So just, that's what that noise
we had
was.
A moment.
I haven't listened to you, and now I'm terrified too.
Me too. I saw it, but I didn't. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. So I'm going to say that half of the table here is probably in a weird mood because we were at a stamp ceremony this morning, and the other half is in a weird mood because you guys weren't there.
We have no excuse. So. We just are.
I've just been with children.
Yeah.
Well, so. Kind of us too.
I've raised 3 children. Is that count?
I will say we really assembled the characters of the town of Santa Claus today for the first issuance of a new stamp.
Very exciting.
Yeah, it was neat.
So what
yeah.
does it look like?
Saint Nick visits.
Yep.
So there's 4 scenes of Santa Claus.
You've got a okay. computer.
We've got some. We've got
I
some do. Pins here.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, here's one of them anyway. Here, pass that down to Matt.
Wi-Fi.
I think these are.
Nell secured us some additional pins.
So they revealed the stamps. I highly encourage you to go online and check it out. But
that is really cute.
They're really neat.
I love the artwork for them.
Yeah. And,
who did the artwork? Do you know?
They said it. It would be cool if we knew that on the top.
Yeah, they did.
Of
they did
insert
say
name
it.
Here.
Yeah. Yeah. We can do the research and let everybody know.
Yeah. And I took some photos, so maybe I'll send those over to Sabrina
like
for
yes
for sharing yep. Of the giant stamps they unveiled. But yeah, they're really neat looking, and this is a pretty rare thing. Even though we're the town of Santa Claus, I believe the last time a first issue stamp celebration was held here was 2005.
Oh, those are super
and before
cute.
That, I think we had one like, in the 80s.
Yes, 83, I think.
Those are going on my Christmas cards.
Yep, you
Anyone
know it.
He's making a cute little wink yeah. face.
You can buy them today.
Yep.
I think they're available now.
I do believe my mom purchased some first edition for myself.
I think
myself.
She did.
Yes.
Yep. Yeah, she did. Yeah,
but yeah, we'll probably go soon and grab.
I was going to get some, and then I was like, "Well, we don't know how many Christmas cards we're going to have yet, so we'll wait and then go." Yeah.
They're forever stamps.
They're forever stamps. You can use them forever.
All of my stamps year round have Santa on them.
You live in Santa Claus.
It's fine. There was ever a place that's okay. It's true. Santa Claus.
Yeah. All right. Well, I know where I'm going after this. At the post office, it's still open.
Yeah. It hurts to pay that much for stamps. Yeah. But they just
raise the prices.
It is what it is.
Seriously?
Yeah, they just did. Yeah. That's why we bought $11,000 worth.
Nice.
About a month ago.
For the
helping
Santa with his
I need
letters.
To pay better attention to that.
Mm-hmm. I remember I went and bought a roll of stamps on the day that they announced that the prices were going up, and they were like, this is like the last one we have right now. Aww. Everyone made a run on stamps today once the announcement came out.
So
like,
now
packages just went up last weekend.
When you over at the museum and
happy holidays,
you have the team that does that helps Santa with letters. Do you guys submit like an expense report to the North Pole once you buy all those stamps, or how does that work?
You know, that's a great question, and I really wish that someone would pay us.
That's a lot of stamps.
So anyone that's listening, box one, Santa Claus, Indiana, 47579 is where you can send any amount of money. We'll take it all. You can also do our PayPal account on our website.
Okay.
SantaClausMuseum.org.
We do. It's under the donations tab.
You need to get Venmo because a lot of people are starting to use Venmo now.
You know, I noticed that.
Yep.
I have noticed that.
I'm a Venmo user.
I am too. I'm a Cash App and a Venmo user.
I have PayPal and Venmo.
Yeah. Nothing makes me more nosy though than Venmo.
So you like seeing what people hide.
I love seeing
every time I go in there to pay someone. I'm like,
I put mine on private.
Yeah. Someone paid.
Pretty cool
that?
To have. We had some official people out from the United States Postal Service, and
Executive Vice President and Chief Technology Officer from the U.S. Postal Service. That was pretty cool.
I imagine that's a stressful job.
Yeah, it's got to be
from Chicago.
From Chicago.
Yeah, from Chicago. Okay. Nice guy. Nice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You think he bought any stamps?
I don't think he had to buy any.
Is that like a job perk? Do I
get free stamps?
I just think for today, he probably got those.
I feel like in the government, that's got to be an ethics rule.
They had come from Minneapolis, though.
Are there ethics?
Were they doing another ceremony? Yeah.
Are there ethics in the government?
No. Wow, that's a
on the next
turn.
Episode.
Well, and that's how the Ho-Oh-Po ended.
Just kidding.
But they had the former postmasters there, which is really neat. There were four ladies that were there. That was kind of cool. And got a little history about the town and all
that. I thought that was neat. I didn't realize there were five. We're on the fifth location. Fourth or fifth, I can't remember.
Yeah. But
fourth or fifth location for the post office.
That, like the post office building moved, you know, there's some.
I don't know if most listeners are aware, but so the post office at one point was, well, it was the building that's attached to the park, right?
Mm-hmm. It's right across the road from the water tower.
What do you call that? The castle-like looking building?
That's what everyone calls it.
Yep.
Right on the highway there.
And it was another building before that.
Right, that you had to go into the park to go to the post office. And it was not okay to do that.
Yeah, and then they had to add a pedestrian. Didn't they have to add a pedestrian gate at that
maybe
point?
Maybe that's when it happened.
I think I learned through the book that we're all working on.
Yeah, I think that may have been right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And actually, if you include that one, that probably is five.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. But we have the original 1856 one at the museum.
Yep.
That was in front of the postmaster's home.
Very
the
cool.
original
that was the building I went in the other day, right?
Yep.
Where they're working on the letters.
Yes,
I was surprised how good of condition that building was in.
Yeah,
it is. It's just got a couple little spots in the back, but it's really in a good
condition. For how old it is.
Well, y'all had it here. I mean, Holiday World takes care of their things.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
aww, it's true. Thanks.
That's a good point.
We do.
I mean, seriously. Yeah.
Thank goodness we have Tom Berg and our.
We've got
team,
such a great
our building maintenance team.
If you have anything with anything carpentry or building wise at the park, like they're on it before you even ask them to work on it, and it's like magic.
And it's the next tribal day knowledge too. They've been with the park for so long that they know where every little nail and bolt is in the park. Yeah.
And painting.
You know how you have to call, was it 811 before you dig?
Right.
Yes.
Tom Berg is our 811. That's where everything is buried.
He's the database.
Yes.
He is 811 in the park.
Very true.
Fair.
Yeah. I actually talked to James Oliver before he left, and he said that we still have to call 811, but then they come out here and they realize that Tom's there, and they're like, "You don't need us."
That's perfect.
Yeah, we're done.
That's awesome.
That's perfect.
Like I said, he's one and the same. Yeah. Shall we jump into some Holiday World feedback?
Let's do it.
Feedback. We're a little light this period, so people, you know.
Feedback light.
Feedback light. It's going to be cool, though.
That's
so,
the thing.
First we heard from hashtag Hot Mess Express at the Davey Boy Show. I feel like he always has a different name every time we hear from him.
I know.
He said, catching up on Holiday World, hashtag Ho Wo Po, I made some KFC famous bowls for dinner to celebrate National Chicken Month. So good. They look delicious. Mm-hmm. Homemade, man.
That's impressive.
I know.
Yeah.
Or something like
looks
that.
Looks great.
Yeah.
I'm impressed.
Reminds me of something you might be able to get at Plymouth Rock.
It does. Mm-hmm. It does.
That's kind of what really I thought tasty. It was.
I thought it was when I first saw the picture.
I was like, is that a turkey bowl?
Yeah.
Because
you should try
chicken.
One of those.
Yeah. Oh, side note. Matt and I went to the Fall Fest, speaking of these delicious looking things,
mm-hmm.
Which, guys, if you haven't been to the Evansville West Side Nut Club Fall Festival, did I get it right?
Yep.
Whenever the first weekend of October, mm-hmm. if you want something extra fun to do when you come to visit, go stay in Evansville and go check out the street festival there. They have fried everything.
Everything.
Yeah.
Fried cookie
fried
dough.
Butter?
Oreos.
I don't know if they had fried butter.
They used to have fried butter.
We did a couple
of our tummies were a little upset afterwards.
But what are the,
we've been like eating a very healthy have lately.
Brain
lately.
Sandwiches.
Yeah.
Like,
sandwiches.
Yes.
Yep.
We
bugs.
Had a
lots of bugs.
Grippo's breaded grilled cheese that was, oh,
yeah, it was good. Had a little kick to it.
Sign me up.
Yes.
It's a great event to take a friend with and split everything.
Yes. We split some items. Yeah.
They probably go as a group. Do not try to go as a single person.
No.
No.
I highly recommend the lunch hour also.
Yeah.
That's the best time to go with less spooky stuff going on, and it's daylight. You can see what's going on, and the crowds are way smaller.
Yeah. The crowds at night can get a little like big.
Yes.
And,
yeah.
And people do go and drink at some of the bars. It's nice during the daytime, though. Yeah.
It's like the longest continual running festival. Obviously, they had a break last year because of COVID.
Yeah.
I truly believe it's longer than Mardi Gras.
Yes.
And
wow.
It's the,
wow.
They boast the second largest street festival.
Yes.
Second to Mardi Gras.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Yep.
Yes.
Yeah. It's that big
I didn't like, I haven't fact checked that, but
I'm pretty sure that's right.
Okay. That's what I've heard.
Wow. That's usually what the news says whenever they cover it. It's usually, it's either like.
It is large.
It is very large. They take over several blocks.
I don't want to throw out numbers.
West Side,
like,
Evansville.
So many. Food trucks. Mm-hmm. And stands.
Oh my gosh! Yeah.
Like,
well, and they're light this year, so some people pulled out this year. But
I saw that.
Yes,
still is a huge and great spread, and we still made ourselves very sick eating there. So
I bet
a lot of places.
So was still the best thing you ate then?
I had a crab dip, which is in retrospect, really good. I've had some intestinal issues this morning, and maybe crab dip from a street festival wasn't the best choice I ever made.
We had the best chocolate chip cookies you've ever had. They're like
just
in a weird shape. They're like
Just Remy's cookies.
Those are good cookies.
Yeah, they're awesome.
Best
They're like a cookie that's as tall. As it is wide.
Yeah.
I still don't know how they do it.
They're like little mounds.
Right.
Remember the year we hosted Golden Tickets? We had Just Rennie's cater some cookies for us.
It's like they scoop them with an ice cream scoop because they're really tall and they're gooey in the middle.
That's how I'd describe it.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. And they also have very good green beans if you ever get their catering.
Okay.
I used to do their, like, anytime we had an Evansville event or an event that I used to do a lot of stuff with, like, regionally in Southern Indiana. And so I'd have to get creative sometimes if there wasn't a company and be like, we'll just get Just Rennie's. It's fine.
So were they as good as your grandma's green beans?
I can't say that on air.
Yeah. Grandma's green beans looked really good.
They were really good. And I brought in green beans the other day, and Matt was like, those look like good green beans. And she is not, her green bean crop wasn't very good. So I legitimately was going to bring you more.
Well, tell her I'm waiting.
Okay. I will. I actually told her. She's like, oh, he liked my green beans.
Well, I didn't get to try it. We ate them all. But.
That's what I said. I was like, I was eating out of the bowl, but.
But yeah, anyway. So that's my little food detour there. Next we heard from MB Photography at M Brook Photo. This was the person who let me know that it was Middle Child Day.
Mm.
halfway through the day. She said, "You're welcome for the reminder. I might be behind on checking Twitter, but I did hear my shout out in the recent feedback episode. I was dying laughing." Aww, thank funny. You for reminding us, because we middle children often forget ourselves.
Yes.
Lauren's eye rolling at me.
All right. Next,
my middle child does not let herself be forgotten. So
that's true. Some they're different personality types of the middle child. Mm-hmm. Some of us just roll with being forgotten, and some of us demand.
I did a fact check. Sorry, I'm just going to do it really quick. Yep. Paula Harvey once called it the second largest street festival behind Mardi Gras.
And it was close.
Okay. Sorry.
But got those backwards, but wanted to correct ourselves.
It was really big.
Yeah.
They say 100 to 150,000 people a night.
Wow.
Really?
I believe
it. Seriously?
That's what Wikipedia
said. I mean, have you been there on a Friday night?
Wikipedia, that's right.
We luckily went in the middle of the afternoon on a Wednesday.
But it was still big. I mean,
yeah, it was still busy, but it wasn't like elbow to elbow.
Yeah, no, I don't. I said I don't venture that way on a night. On especially like weekends. No, I don't venture that way.
I also don't recommend the Friday. I don't know if it's the Thursday and Friday, but the school's actually let out for a really famous tug of war contest, which is adorable. Mm. It's like a fifth grader rite of passage. They like have a little contest.
I just thought most Evansville schools are just out on that like Friday. Of the fall
it's
fest.
It's like a holiday for Evansville.
It's like a holiday.
Yep. Like Derby Day. And then that's a huge fundraiser. A lot of places. That's like that's it for the year. They just have their booth and, you know, churches and stuff. Mm-hmm. So it's pretty cool stuff.
Yeah. I bet they make some good money, even though like everything is like $6.
Yeah.
It's amazing. It is
good.
Anyway.
Sorry.
Next we heard, I'm glad we learned something new today.
Don't want to give false information.
Next we heard from LindsayTV/film at History_Leisure. Holiday World, I have an idea for Teddy Bear Day. Figure out what Matt B's belly badge would look like. His surname is Bloomheart, after all. Hashtag ho-wo-po, hashtag Care Bears. What would Matt's?
What?
Belly badge. Oh, Care I guess Bears. The Care Bears, the thing is on like their belly.
Like the rainbow.
Oh, I think I saw
it.
It'd
be like a bad food
Twitter,
pyramid or something.
I know. I'm like, it's something food related.
It's just like a pile of brown food.
A bottle of ranch dressing.
I'm so lost. With plain cheesecake.
Yeah. I like how he spelled my last name.
What is belly badge?
It's the little circle thing on the Care Bears.
On the Care Bears.
It's like a rainbow.
I've never had a Care Bear.
But you've never seen them?
See a Care Bear ever
in your
life? I've
seen like, aren't they all like different colors and have different pictures on them? Yeah,
that's what they're talking about.
That's what we're
talking
about.
It's like a circle that's different than their other
belly. But why is it a bag?
Badge.
That makes more sense. Okay.
We're together now.
Yes.
So
it's a belly bag. So I'm like picturing this little like
like a fanny pack.
Fanny pack. Like why are Care Bears wearing
like
fanny
a
packs?
Kangaroo pouch.
Belly badge. Okay. Gotcha.
They have things on their belly.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I knew that. Okay. I just didn't remember a fanny pack.
I mean, like the way he spelled.
We can get one for Matt. That would be a fanny pack.
Christmas list noted.
The way he spelled like Bloomheart, you could do like a little flower and a heart, like but you know, but actually Matt would, you know, it would be some sort of food related.
A piece of pizza.
Let's see. Next, we heard from HWSS Superfan at HWSS Superfan. Middle child love coming this season. Hashtag ho-wo-po. Red heart, yellow heart, blue heart. Love that. Even if they do forget their own day. Much love to you, FGOLK. So now I'm fourth generation owner, Leah Cook.
Very nice.
Okay.
The acronym grows.
We announced recently that we will be doing some off-season track work on The Legend. I didn't ask you for a formal update, Matt, but can you provide us with an update?
It's going very well.
We're on the spot.
we've got a lot of scope, a lot of areas of the ride that we're focused on. And so that was why we kind of made the decision. Let's close Legend a little early because we want to make sure we have all the track work ready to go for next season. So I think we gave people a little bit of notice at least. They could come and get their last rides of the season. I saw several people at the Ace event that we recently had that were there the weekend before to get their last Legend rides in. But we're right now we're focusing on the second half of the Helix element. So we are doing the top two layers on the whole second half. And it's kind of crazy. So we closed the ride the last operating day of September. And I go out there 2 or 3 days into the week, and they're already, they've already ripped all the top two layers off our coaster guys for the, for that section of the ride. And they'd already started putting fresh lumber down.
Wow.
I'm like, how do you guys move so quickly?
We don't mess around.
Yeah. So they're just, our coaster team is, you give them marching orders and they are going to, they're going to stay here until it's done. Yeah. So they're working through, I mean, it's probably, honestly, all the lumber's probably up there at this point. They're probably cutting the curves in and then getting ready to put track steel back on. But I haven't been out the ride in about a week. So anyway, we're working on that section. We're smoothing out some track after the spiral element, but before you go into that next tunnel. So there's a camel hump there.
I have to say, can I interrupt? Yeah. When we made the announcement, we had people who hadn't read the blog post that I put a lot of time and energy into. Rude. not that I'm bitter. It's fine. But they were talking about, you know, could you please, if there are two spots that you hit, make it the bottom of the spiral and make it the second half of the helix. And I'm like, that's what we're doing. And I told you
in the blog. I will
say, just go and
read it.
I have ridden the Legend this summer, probably more than any of our other coasters and rode it with our coaster guys and with our friends from the Gravity Group who are helping us reprofile some sections. And that's who we typically work with when we do extensive wooden coaster work. And we know that ride like the back of our hands in terms of what areas need attention to smooth out the ride experience. So yeah, we are doing some areas around the camel hump. And then, as you mentioned, the spiral, that's where our most extensive work is going to take place. We're doing all 8 layers from the top all the way down through the bottom and even slightly up into the incline, into the next hill after the spiral. So I think it's well over 400 feet of track in total. I think it's 420 or 450. I can't remember the exact number, but it's a lot of track. And it's going really well, but our coaster guys are going to have their work cut out for them once they get the helix done, because they're going to move into that spiral and they're going to have a nice, workload this off season to make sure they get all that done.
Yep.
But right now we met with Gravity Group recently, and they're providing, you know, their engineers take a look at the, original design forces of the ride. And they look at how the ride's currently running. So we do dynamic testing with an accelerometer. And then that's kind of how we, you know, along with riding the ride, that's how we identify, you know, what we want to do. So do we want to change the banking angle on this particular part of the ride? Or do we want to move some ledgers up and down to give the track more strength and smooth things out? Because if you have a coaster there for 20 years, you know, these wooden coasters are living, breathing machines.
Yep.
You have to constantly make tweaks. And we certainly don't just let our wooden coasters sit there.
Nope.
We're always working on them. So, but anyway, Legend Project is going very well.
And laterals are staying there.
Yes. It's still That's the most important ride. You know, you're going to find some slight adjustments we're going to make on that spiral to make it a more comfortable experience. But you're not going
to any enthusiasts who want it the most intense. Yeah. Sorry.
You know,
we have to think about our regular guests first.
Yeah. So we want to make sure
we love you guys, but
we want to make sure it's a comfortable experience. And we want to make sure that the ride stays smooth and comfortable for years to come. So,
get ready for 22.
Yes.
Yep.
The laterals will still be there.
Yep. Absolutely. All right. We also heard from Coaster Force, who came out and shot some incredible footage of our coasters this year. They said, check out our newest 4K 60 frame per second POV of Holiday World's Thunderbird. Is this the best B&M wing coaster on earth?
Yeah.
And of course, I shared and said, are we allowed to weigh in?
winky face?
Some high praise. I said that's some high praise.
Yeah.
I'm here for it. Thank you.
I'll take it.
Thank you.
We heard from Andy, is it Guinigundo? Matt, you know.
Guinigundo.
Okay.
That's a cool last name.
Attractions OOTL. It's the best of the American installs. It may be the best, but I've only been on the U.S. installs. In my order, 1 Thunderbird, 2 Gatekeeper, 3 X-Flight, and 4 Wild Eagle.
Wow.
And is a very smart man, too.
That's awesome. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I haven't been on X-Flight, but I've been on, obviously, Thunderbird, Gatekeeper, and Wild Eagle, and I would agree.
Mm-hmm. Wow, that's great.
With his assessment there, I think that's pretty accurate.
I have
not
been on Gatekeeper, but I've been on the other two.
Look at all the love for Thunderbird today.
I've been on
Gatekeeper. It's cool. I mean, it's a good ride.
I've been on Wild Eagle.
Just the launch is what. Thunderbird. But the launch and the fact that we're out in the woods just makes it something special.
For sure. Yes, it does.
Yeah. The
fly-through barn, let's be honest. That fly-through barn
that is
makes
pretty neat.
It, yeah.
It is.
And then I also just want to say thank you to all of our ACE members who did come out for the Quoth the Raven Ride Some More event. It was a great event, and thank you all for bearing with us while Thunderbird gave us some technical issues first thing in the morning for your ERT. But we had a great little sign shop tour. They got to see some of the history that stays in Rick's shop, because, you know, he's been around for 46 years
now.
So.
Oh, my gosh. Wow.
Some really cool signs in there. Like, as Josh and I went through and we're kind of thumbing through them to, like, get things out that they'd be interested in seeing. I'm like, I'm interested in seeing this. This is really cool.
We got some merch ideas from that, Matt.
Yeah. Oh, can I talk about some new merch? Is that appropriate?
Sure, why not? I mean...
Well,
it's not on my schedule, but whatever.
Sorry. This is one of my favorite times of the year because we start to develop new product for next year. So Made to Thrill has obviously been hugely popular.
For our park and now for Copycat Park, Cedar Point and Kings Island.
You know, we...
I say with love. I'm very happy for Josh at Made to Thrill.
We had some great success with working with Josh at Made to Thrill. And we were actually the first park to work with him.
I'm very happy to see him succeeding for real.
One of my good friends, one of my former colleagues from Cedar Point had reached out to me when they saw the artwork, and they asked, you know, if we could help get them in touch. And so I connected Made to Thrill with Cedar Point, and now the Cedar Fair parks are doing some pretty cool art with Josh as well. So
good for Josh.
Exactly.
I think he's overwhelmed with the amount of business.
Cedar Fair, that's a lot of work.
He's got a unique talent.
He's great to work with though. But so I was working on the order the other day. I like to help. My background's in merchandise, if the listeners don't know. So I like to help Vanessa, who's our very talented director of retail, with orders here and there in the off season, because she's got a lot of product to order, particularly
this year.
We're bone dry on inventory, thanks to the pent-up demand we had this year.
Seriously.
Yeah. Not a whole lot left in the gift shops, but it's a good problem to have. Yeah.
And you can find it at the museum in December.
Yes, we do. Some of our assortment now takes over to the museum. So
get there early, guys.
So we're reordering everything that's in our current assortment with Made to Thrill. So the the original
obviously
Landsea
the limited
Airtime.
Edition will not be back.
Yeah, the limited edition 2020 one shirt will obviously not be back. It was a limited edition, but all of the t-shirts and posters and the stickers we're going to be doing in a combo pack. If you've seen how Cedar Point does it, they put all their stickers into a little cello bag with a header card on it. We're going to do our stickers in a combo pack now.
Love a good sticker set.
Yeah, you got to love a sticker set. Yeah. And I'm talking to Josh about doing some, we're in talks with Josh about potentially doing some magnets with some of this artwork as well. Very so cool. People can round out their collections. And then we're doing two new programs with him. We're going to do a Frightful Falls vintage program, and we're doing a Raging Rapids vintage program with him.
That's fun.
So there will be a t-shirt art for each of those. And then there will be obviously a separate artwork that will go on the posters and the stickers. And then we'll see what art would go on magnets. But
we're going to have to start designating just like a Made to Thrill section of the gift shop.
It's funny you mentioned that because
that would be awesome. Yeah. Honestly.
Vanessa was just in Vegas at one of the many retail shows she goes to, and she brought back some photos of some different displays that she saw in some of the souvenir shops in Vegas on the strip. And we talked about that, doing a whole wall for Made to Thrill, because we're really leaning into it this year.
It's almost a whole wall already.
It's the whole concept of shop within a shop.
Yes.
It makes it feel really special, which I mean, it already is. Yeah. So we might as well treat it that way. Yeah.
So it's very possible when you come to the park next year, if you go into St. Nick's, you're probably going to see a very large statement of Made to Thrill, probably an entire wall.
I love all of it, but the Santa Claus land, I think design may be my...
That's
all-time
fave. I wear that shirt all the time. That'll be returning.
Oh, me too.
The posters in my office.
Yep. That's awesome.
I had people say, "Can I get that?" I'm like, "Sorry, it's limited edition."
Yeah. Well, we've got the Santa
Claus
land.
The black shirt
land.
Or the Santa Claus
the black
land?
One.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
The black one.
You got to check out this Santa Claus land. We took the old, it's like a 1950s bright color
Incredible.
Santa Claus land logo. That's and cool. put it on a gray, like a dark gray tee in it.
Do y'all have those now?
Yes.
Yes. And we actually still have some of those.
You would really like that.
We have some of those.
Yeah.
We did as of a couple of weeks ago, but, you know, as you run out of other things, they start to deplete the inventory.
Actually, okay. it's on my Christmas card last year.
Yeah. There you go.
Oh, yeah. We had those last year.
It's a neat looking shirt. Yeah. So
I like that too.
So anyway, Made to Thrill. And then we've got other things we're doing.
Yeah.
We're doing a new, so it'll be our third year with a large water globe for the park? I think it's year three. So the first year we did the Skyline. And then this last year we did the same water globe with a new 75th limited edition wrap on the bottom. And now I'm working on a totally new water globe design, new wrap and new insides. Mm-hmm. So if you like collecting snow globes or water globes or whatever you want to call it, we're going to have yet another iteration of that for 2022.
Nice.
So have I gone too long with the merchandise talk?
We have a lot of fans of those snow globes, but the smaller ones.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Well, we're also reordering the smaller Santa Claus statue, mm-hmm. Santa Claus Land. All of our stuff is sold out essentially. Mm-hmm. So I was actually just emailing with our vendor on that one. We're reordering the Santa Claus statue mini snow globe.
That's the one they like.
And then we've got, this one's kind of cool. So we have these really cool flexible magnets. If you've been in our gift shops, they're like kind of metallic looking and they've got some cool art and they continue to sell out.
People have reached out to us to ask who does those.
Who does these? And, so we're doing a new magnet this year that's going to be the Holiday World Water Tower.
That's
just kind of a fun. It'll have the vintage Holiday World logo, just the single without the splash and safari.
Oh, that's awesome! I like that.
So that'll be our new magnet, and then we're reordering a bunch of
the
other
water tower.
But, yeah,
you know, before you know it, 100 years is going to roll around, and we should give the water tower the spaceship Earth treatment that I got for the 50th Disney World.
Have it light up.
Yeah,
I love it.
That'll be kind of epic, actually.
Yeah, I know. Gaudy, amazing. I don't know. You decide.
But awesome at the same time.
So, does anyone want to guess real quick, and then I can let you take your podcast back. does anybody want to guess?
This is my merch corner with Matt.
Yeah. You pirated it.
Merch Mondays with Matt, even though it's not Monday.
You know, he said
it'll release on a Monday.
He said that we should rename this one the one with Matt Bloomhart. He wasn't kidding.
Wow.
And Matt took it and ran.
I'm in rare form. Sometimes I get distracted during these and I'll be doing emails, but I'm really engaged today.
It's because you're putting yourself at the center of attention.
Yes, I'm just talking.
I feel like I'm the normal Matt Bloomhart today. So.
Matt and Matt have traded places. Okay, so my question is, what do you think our number one selling SKU is in merchandise at Holiday World?
Tie-dye shirt.
That's the number one apparel.
Okay.
I think I know what it is.
In quantity. So you're right on apparel. That is our number one apparel.
I think you've told me. So I'll let other people guess first.
The waterproof cell phone bag.
Boom.
Yep. Yes.
That's what I was
going to say. Our custom branded, it's called a triple seal beach safe.
Whatever it's called. Yeah.
He calls it a beach safe. And I picture those like little things you can hook onto chairs.
But that's our number one in quantity. The tie dye is our number one apparel item in dollars.
Okay.
Our number one quantity apparel item is actually now our yearly collectible promotional t-shirt that we do.
Hey.
We're selling every year. Exponential growth on that program.
Yeah, awesome.
So we're working on the art for next year. We don't have it settled yet, but I need to get that done soon.
Can we have the
reminder?
We're up against the wall.
The coffee mug that we did with a promo tee years ago back.
Oh, yes.
I want that one.
Well, we are going
to
do
the one we sent to the governor for his COVID chats.
We are actually, I'm glad you brought up the mug.
That was awesome.
Yes. We actually, so that year we had a.
You're loving this now. I'm increasing your time.
The art that was on the mug matched the promotional t-shirt that year. So we made the mug a promo item and gave it for like $4.99 or something. Mm-hmm. It was a really great deal. We're going to do the same thing for 2022. So we're doing a new mug. So the mug is going to match the artwork on whatever the promotional t-shirt looks like.
Nice.
So there will be a mug.
So there will be one that matches this year's promo tee.
Yes.
Okay.
So we're bringing the mug back, and then maybe the next year we'll do something else, and then maybe we'll do a mug again. We like to kind of, you know, we don't want to do the same thing every year. We try to mix it up.
Mix it up.
Keep people interested and, you know, Make sure you collect your promotional t-shirt. I see families walking around the park and everybody's got them on. And
yep. That and their limited edition t-shirt. That's how you know the real fans. Yeah, when you see the really limited edition t-shirt in the park. That's how you know. So
thanks for letting me promote the merchandise. And great job to Vanessa, who's a trooper and has done a great job this season keeping the stores as stocked as we possibly can with all the supply chain challenges.
Yeah.
And just a thing, I will be joining and helping buy in a Gatlinburg show. So email podcast at Holiday World if you have suggestions for merch. I honestly would have a ball reading this.
We're going on a buying trip with Vanessa to assist. No. And she's going to give us a list of vendors and we're going to split up at the show and see what happens.
Too funny.
I just got to go spend money. This is great.
That's awesome. Like a big
old shopping that's how this works.
I mean, we're buying for next year. I think it's a record amount of merchandise because
we have nothing.
We
right
have
now.
Nothing left. So it's going to be a lot of fresh new souvenirs next year.
And that's a awesome warehouse. Yeah. You very much see through the shelves
you
at this
can.
Point.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. It's, which I
yeah.
love.
Yeah. Yeah. Right. Yeah.
As a finance guy. Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right, guys.
So we've liquidated a lot of merchandise.
We have liquidated a lot of merchandise.
Kind
of
like how Matt liquidated the
deer.
The petting
zoo. Well, I was honestly going to say, too, that like at this point, I think we know the things that aren't going to sell. Like,
right.
We've learned if they're not moving right now. Vanessa's been doing a good job, though. She's marking that stuff down. Because it's like if it doesn't move at this point, we know. Mm-hmm. You know, you just... When you're buying, Matt has advised me, you know, you just don't hit 100. You don't bat 1,000.
Never will.
Sometimes you buy stuff and you're like, why did I do that?
Yep. We brought
that's the name of the game.
That's Sandusky
swag.
But then
sometimes there's stuff that are bought. I'm like, I ask that question, why did we buy that? And then we sell it like crazy.
Yeah. Yes. Yep. Or you just never know. Like, you guys had those pennants. You guys haven't been able to sell them.
We didn't sell the pennants and they went crazy for you guys.
Wow.
Yes.
Huh.
Yeah.
I just remember the year Vanessa bought a ton of like hot dog hats. I'm like, nobody is going to buy those. I bet I saw 50 people wearing hot dog hats in the park that day. Like, it was like,
people love those crazy
they
hats.
They do. Okay.
That's right.
Whenever we were on vacation, I know we talked about the tie-dye shirts before, how popular they are. And I went and I looked all over their merch shop for like something different, but I fell in love with the tie-dye shirt. And I was like, well, here I am on vacation doing touristy things.
In the world of souvenirs and souvenir apparel, tie-dye t-shirts, or just tie-dye shirts in general, is probably the longest running fad.
Yeah.
I mean, back when I was a seasonal at Cedar Point, like a long time ago, and we always said, oh, this is going to burn out the next year, and then it never did. It just kept gaining steam.
And then now you have millennials who like grew up with it. Now it's nostalgia. Yeah. Like, you know.
Oh my gosh, the things kids are wearing right now. I'm like, wait, this was like in style whenever I was a child.
Yep.
Why are these kids trying to get rid
of my skinny jeans right now and give me like mom jeans or like Junko jeans or whatever. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, no. I didn't fall for it back then. I'm not falling for it now.
It's all the bucket hats that are killing me right now.
Yes. Yeah. Well, we got to get a bucket hat for next year.
That's another one. In the world of souvenir hats, bucket hats have been a theme park staple
for years. Bucket hats are very big right now.
Yep. And that kind of started with sports. It's interesting to see who starts the trends.
Like, people love the bucket hats.
It's like, is it the sports world? Is it pop culture? Like, who? But the bucket hat. That,
you
like,
can't
but
keep
there's always
hats
a dad
stock.
Buying a bucket hat at a park, no matter if it's in style. Yeah. There will always be a dad buying a bucket hat.
Bald dad buying a bucket hat. Dave has like 10. That's fair. Just saying. That's all I'm saying.
For happy Halloween weekends, I'm gonna be a soaring thunderbird.
I'll be a real bird, the raven, flying through the woods and over the water.
I'm feeling like a pilgrim on the voyage, going over one of the world's steepest drops.
Huh, guess I'm a mind reader. I already bought our Holiday World tickets.
Wow! Yeah!
Woo! Be whatever you want at Holiday World each weekend through October. Do a corn maze, walk through the scare B&B, and go trick-or-treating. Get tickets at holidayworld.com.
Want to make a suggestion or have questions for the Pod Squad? There are more ways than ever to reach out to the podcast.
Find at Holiday World on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram and use the hashtag HOWOPO to let us know you're talking about us.
You can now call us. Dial 812-937-4401 and type in extension 8081 to get to the Ho-Wo-Po voicemail box.
Leave your questions and feedback for us there, or you can email us at podcast@holidayworld.com, either with a written message or with a voice memo.
Again, reach out on social media to @HolidayWorld and use the hashtag Ho-Wo-Po, or call us at 812-937-4401, extension 8081, or send us an email to podcast@holidayworld.com. Want to know a secret? The best time to buy season passes is always right now. It's that simple. We believe in transparent pricing, so there's no game to play and no complications. Prices increase throughout our off-season, so hurry and buy now. We have 3 different passes with different perks, so go to holidayworld.com/passes to pick the pass that fits your family best. All right, well, we are Holiday World, and we love holidays. October 18th is Clean Your Virtual Desktop Day. Mm. Are you guys messy? I'm a messy virtual desktop person. Yep.
Oh, totally. Mine's terrible.
Mine's pretty clean.
It's covered in icons.
That's what I was going to say.
Mine's not.
Mine's always a mess because it's just whatever I need, whatever I've been working on the most recently. Like, once every so often, I'll go and, like, move them all into some folders. But
I don't clean mine up.
Nope.
It just stays messy.
Everything has to be organized for me.
That doesn't surprise me.
My email's what's really bad.
Yeah, my email's not organized.
My email's
really bad.
I just have sorry, inbox. Casey. I know, I just have the inbox. Giant inbox that I'm sure I need to go and delete things. But.
Yeah.
But then you go to delete it and like, I don't know. I might go back and look at this.
I did a massive like purge a few years ago, and I've already had a few times where I was like, I deleted it.
I just get so many emails every day.
Well, I'm sure you do, and
it's just like it's impossible to just, you know, I open all the ones I know are critical, but there's so many things you get copied on. It's just like, I'll get back to that, and then I never get back to it.
I have 362 that are unread right now.
I'm not going to admit how many I have.
I have been working my tail off to keep it to like 150 unread, and at any given time, like I always have at least 150 unread. But like I've been working hard right this week to.
That's
keep
impressive
it down
though
there.
For you because you get so many emails from guests.
And we just get spam.
Yeah,
you know, Fun at Holiday World gets all kinds of spam. So. Mm-hmm. It's great. It's a good time. We love it. Anyway, October 19th is Evaluate Your Life Day. Clear your calendar for that day, guys.
I don't know if that's good or bad.
Honestly, for me, I feel like it's just like every full moon is when I what am I doing with my life right now when I'm like being beat up by guests who...
I'm not getting beat up by guests, but I get beat up by my children when there's a full moon. Yeah. Similar.
Again, about once a month, I think I'm evaluating my life.
Yeah, that's right.
Mercury is currently in retrograde, if anyone is following along.
Oh, yeah. We had the big outage.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, gosh.
For those of you listening in the future, the outage is still fresh for us. Good times. Let's see. October 20th is International Chef Day, International Sloth Day, and Suspender Day.
Sloths.
Sloths were really popular there for a while. Mm-hmm.
Yes, thank you, Kristen Bell.
I attribute that to Kristen Bell.
I would say yes, it's probably Kristen Bell.
I just know there was a big sloth thing. Yeah. We actually had quite a bit of sloth merch that year.
I feel like there's always big at the games.
Yeah,
there's always like an animal of the year. So there's like llamas were big for a while. Yep. And like
unicorns,
hedgehogs.
Are big.
Yeah,
gorillas were big back when I worked at Cedar Point in games.
It's just like always like the animal of the year.
I think like cartoon sloths are always like pretty big. But yes, sloths really had a moment.
They had a
after
big
Kristen
moment.
Bell's video went viral. Yeah.
Sloths were just slower to catch on.
See what I did there. We actually bought the sloth, the grow your own sloth from the, that was a Liberty Bell shop. That was a very enjoyable 48-hour process.
Grow your own sloth?
It's in our merch shop. It's a grow your own sloth.
Really?
Yes. We have that at our park?
Yes, we do have that.
I'm going to need more information.
We still have it.
Everything that's bought.
Is this like chia? Is this like crystals? How do you grow it?
I know. I'm like, was it made out of?
Was it like an Orbeez?
Are you making this up?
I'm not. And I don't have a picture of it, but now when I go home, I'll have to go.
Like washcloths?
Kind of.
Right.
It was in an egg and you put the egg in water and it had to be submerged.
Okay.
And then I think the egg was supposed to crack, but Savannah, I was a little distracted and she kept going, open it, open it, open it, open it. And I was like, I'm busy. And she's like, open it, open it. And then I opened it and I cracked the egg. But I think you're supposed to leave it in the egg, in the water, and the egg is supposed to crack. And then the sloth also grows.
But wait, back up. Are sloths born in eggs?
I don't think so. That seems like a mammal. Look,
this is it's not a real
No, wait,
what is a sloth?
No.
It's not like, a real sloth. This is a real sloth?
No. I am going, this is not a real sloth.
Kind of like those sea monkey things years ago.
Gosh, no. Yeah.
This is a pretend. Real and pretend. This is pretend.
I knocked over the tank one time and they went all over the place.
Oh, no.
You were. Yeah.
Sea monkeys everywhere.
Yeah.
R.I.P.
Yep.
But yeah, so he like doubled or tripled in size. It was a fun little. He
well,
had,
now
like,
I want to see this. Where are they?
They're in Liberty Bell shop.
There's probably none. There's probably none left. Like everything else is sold out.
It's a limited edition sloth. Sorry. Yeah, I think there were also unicorns and other animals and llamas maybe, but Savannah
and they all
chose
came out of eggs.
Sloths. Yes.
Correct. Yeah.
There you go.
It's not very educational for our children.
That's it.
Technically accurate.
Lauren
found a photo.
She's studying and not letting us see.
Sorry. I need to.
Do you have a YouTube video of it happening? Like,
oh, I'm sure some kid has like
freeze frames.
Hold on. I'm trying to get.
Some kid has $500,000.
So here's the little box.
Okay.
Okay.
It's very tiny on the screen. Right
I know.
Now.
I'm sorry. Here.
There we go.
He looks kind of spongy.
Yeah, okay. That's kind of what I imagined the texture.
Yeah, that's cute.
Yep. No, that's cute. Okay.
That's not what I pictured in my head.
A very strange, slimy texture on it. I don't know.
Well, that's what I pictured, like this little slimy.
Yep. It did.
See, that looks cute.
I rinsed him off.
Fish.
I don't know if I was supposed to, but I didn't like it, so I rinsed it.
Well, he just came out of an egg. Of course he's going to
have. Right?
Is he like a stuffed animal?
No, he's like a sponge. It almost reminds me of like, do you remember like the eraser toppers? That's what he reminds me of.
Do you still have it?
Yes, I'll bring him in.
How big is it?
Like, yay big. Like 3 inches or 4 inches tall.
So bigger than a pencil.
We've had so many questions.
Or the sloth in a box. No, sloth in an egg. I'm
in
sorry.
An egg in a box. So.
Wow.
Yeah. But that
look for those on your buying trip this year. Find the newest animal in an egg.
Okay. Grow your own pets.
That's my goal when we're in Gatlinburg is to find more of those.
Zero in on it.
We'll just throw away the other holidays.
I don't know what the animal is
time.
This year, but.
All right, moving on to October 21st, which is Apple Day, sure, and Conflict Resolution Day. I had to include Conflict Resolution Day because of The Office.
Because The Office, yeah, that's what I figured.
There's an entire episode dedicated to
it. It's funny that comes
horrible.
2 days after Evaluate Your Life Day.
Yeah.
think about what you've done.
You've got a day to prepare yourself to resolve the conflicts in your life. I like it. October 22nd is Caps Lock Day, which I needed to call out just for, you know, Josh,
necessary?
Sabrina, and I work in communications and in social media, and just the amount of caps, all caps lock.
Mm-hmm.
Just a friendly reminder for your, you know, whenever you're going to message any sort of business or whatever, just make sure that caps lock stays off when you email. It comes across a shouting, whether or not you mean it to, and it hurts the feelings. And we read it a little more defensively. I'm sorry.
We love our guest feedback, but it doesn't need to be in all caps.
Don't yell at us.
It's like this younger generation in punctuation.
Yes.
It's like you can even say, you guys are awesome in all caps.
I said one to you, I had a question mark and a couple exclamation marks.
Also, mixed caps. I can't mix caps.
Oh, no, I'm not like that. I appreciate punctuation.
Me too.
It makes me think of when we were working from home heavily, like all the time, that for whatever reason, my computer, when I remote in, will randomly put caps locks in. So I would send like Josh and Liam messages to me, all caps, like, sorry, I wasn't yelling. For some reason, I have to hit alt every now and then, and it would be fine.
Did,
like,
you, know
the rest
that,
of
did you know that punctuation in text messages can indicate anger too? I didn't know that. Mm-hmm.
Like, but you're not supposed to.
You're not supposed to punctuate your last sentence.
My kids don't even punctuate anything. Like, they sent something the other day, and I just respond with "Okay, period." And they're like, "Why are you mad?"
Yeah. I got that one time from one of my kids too.
I said, "I'm not mad."
Yes,
no.
And
you guys.
Then I said, and so then I just responded with "K," the letter K. They're like, "Do
that's
not
even worse.
Do that."
Yeah. No.
Why?
What's worse than that is KK.
So I'm like, okay, I'm not texting you anymore today.
Yeah, I'm finished.
Period.
I'm going to do that later.
Smiley face.
Do you guys do two periods after your sentence? This was something I brought up. A radio station did it, and like it blew up. Like people are like, of course I do two spaces.
Why would you do two spaces?
Two spaces. I was a two periods.
Single. It's single.
Yeah, single. I do two spaces when I type.
I do too. I think
one space.
There was a
grammatical. Yes.
They changed it when we were all in school to one space.
And I will never forget how much I loved. Right. No, I loved the two space rule for writing papers.
Yeah, because you got more space.
Yes.
Exactly.
Yep. And all of a sudden, I did appreciate whenever you were allowed to do either style, because I think whenever I was in school, like sometimes some papers would be in one style, and sometimes they wanted a different style, like. And yeah, the ones where you got to do two, I was like, yes.
Why change it? It's like
those
your
spaces
new
add up.
Like, why do we need the
four
new
spaces? Yes.
Indent.
I thought it was two.
Indent. Yeah. Indent. Tab. Indent.
I think word processors may do a better job of putting space between a period. They may
probably.
Do a little
it has
more
to do with like the change from a key using a typewriter or something like that. That's what I heard. Is like the like you said, word processors do a better job now of managing space.
Yeah.
But I remember that in keyboarding class.
Yeah.
That you had to do two spaces.
Yeah.
So maybe that's where it generated.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Yep.
I love the youths do keyboarding class. I doubt it.
They
right?
don't.
The youths.
Shelby, we had that conversation. I don't know if your girls did in school, but Shelby was like, I was like, why are you typing like that?
Yeah.
And she's like, because it's how I type. And I was like, what? Your hands aren't on home row. And she's like, what
is that?
And they don't. Or they she don't. Did.
Man,
she
Mavis Beacon was like my jam.
Oh,
right?
Mavis Beacon.
Drew has computer science. Like, that's what they do.
Yeah. Really? Loved me some Mavis Beacon.
Was that a real person?
I have no idea.
Probably.
You're maybe. Right.
I just...
The extra space was needed to delineate the beginning of a new sentence because the spacing between words was uneven on a typewriter.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I just absolutely loved every single one of my typing, keyboarding classes, whatever, because I was always one of the fastest ones.
Me
so
too.
Me and whoever else was one of the faster ones, we'd always compete. We'd be like, what was your time? Yep. Oh, it was this. Oh, you got me.
What's your WPM?
Yeah.
Words per minute.
We always competed. It was. I loved it. I love that class.
I like ours too. Was based on like posture and things. Like she would go around.
You have your feet on the ground.
Yeah, feet, knees, 90-degree angles, shoulders
right.
back. It was
okay. That sounds
thing.
Like a thing where like they would also only have like women learn that. So
no, they did everybody.
What does
we
that
sometimes
mean?
Got knocked for bad posture.
And that seems
in my
like
classes.
A thing that like the old school. I don't know. It just seems like a thing that like secretaries
in
needed
my
to have perfect posture and all that.
They just
it's
didn't
like,
want you like.
Yeah, they just wanted to have carpal tunnel.
Okay,
it was
I can
a safety
support
thing.
That. But like,
a safety
why,
thing.
Why
like
does your feet on the ground
ergonomics.
Matter?
I think it all has to do with, you're supposed to, my sister's an occupational therapist. It's the only reason I know this.
Okay.
Everything is
okay.
supposed to be 90 or 40, don't.
You know me.
90 or 180.
Yeah, it probably has to do with. Everything was aligned and whatnot.
Yes.
Matt can confirm for you. I default to Squiggles. Assuming something is sexist. So. In my defense, I live in the
you
United
do?
States of America.
She immediately goes there.
Anyway.
That's October, caps lock day.
Yeah, October 23rd.
We deviate so easily.
We're skipping a lot of holidays in here. Some days we really need a lot of holidays, and today we don't.
We really don't.
We need like two
I
more.
I said buckle up. This was going to be a day. This is the first episode we're recording, too.
One of three. So October 23rd is iPod Day.
Old tech alert.
Do people still have iPods? Like, is that
I have my old
iPod. I know,
iPod.
I still have mine.
Yep.
My like,
do you use
I
it,
have
though?
Like an old technology cabinet
could
in my mom's house.
Yep.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess maybe.
My kids lose that. They have a drawer
my
with
intention
their stuff in it.
Was, well, I guess with my last
one
car, my intention was for it to strictly just stay in my car because I elected to not get a CD player in my previous car.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And I just stopped updating my iPod. I think it's just in a drawer now.
Hmm. But yeah, I've got like a Nano. Yeah.
Yeah.
I have a shuffle somewhere.
Nice. Yes.
Really?
Like the clip-on shuffle?
Yep. Yeah.
It holds like 50 songs.
Yes.
Nice.
Yeah. You could literally shake it and it would change songs.
Yeah. That radio iPod?
Yes.
That Nano, I remember going like on a trip and watching the movie Juno on that like two-inch screen. I mean, I'd seen it before already, but it was like...
That's so funny.
I thought it was the height of technology. You know, like just incredible.
The little thumb pad thing, the circular
spinny wheel. Yeah,
I have to take a moment and call out my dad from the grave because let's see here.
He was so bad at making technology.
Well, he was so against iPods.
He was.
He was so against iPods, and I got it in my head. The first one that had like a color screen. I decided that that was what I wanted for Christmas. Was it, I think they called it the iPod Color.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Even though it was white, but the screen was color.
That was creative.
It was a bit. But it was like still like the brick ones. Like, you know, it wasn't like the really thin ones. It was still brick. And I was like so jazzed about it. I was like, Dad, I really want an iPod. That's what I want. And he's like, are you sure? He's like, I really just don't know that this is the technology you want to follow. And I'm like, no, I want an iPod. So he finally caved and I got an iPod for Christmas.
No. But
it took him several years before he finally got an iPhone.
Yes.
What was
he really stuck to that like path, Windows phone?
Which
for
path
years.
Did he go down though? So he didn't like the iPod. So did he do like a Zune?
No, he wanted mini discs.
Mini discs. Yeah. What's that?
Steven knows
the little CDs.
I've never.
They look like a little like floppy disk almost.
Yeah, I've
they
never look heard of this.
Oh, I still have mine.
Oh, I'm like really? Googling a photo for you. Oh, I've got.
It's the most incredible thing you'll ever see in your life.
Are you sure
see
this? I don't have yours in my old tech cabinet?
No, I still have mine. I have mine. Awesome. I mean, unless like you have my first one that got damaged, but I thought we got rid of that.
It's kind of like a floppy disk and a CD at the same time.
Yeah, it's like
but it's like a CD-R. So you can write things to it. You can erase things from it. You can rearrange tracks and make different playlists.
But it can hold. But it can hold like 4 or 5 hours worth of music.
Really?
Around there? Yeah.
Did it have a screen on it, or how did that work?
I mean, just a little like a CD player
digital readout.
Okay.
Yeah. So like, this one had like a separate plug-in so you could read what was on the track.
Ah.
Sorry.
But yeah, that's like dad did not believe in digital music because at least whenever it first came out, like those devices could only hold like max like 80 songs. And he's like, that's ridiculous. Mm-hmm. He's like, this is not worthwhile technology. He's like, mini discs. That's what you can get behind.
To be fair, when the like Blu-ray HD DVD thing came out too, he went, he steered hard into the HD DVD and clearly Blu-ray won out.
So he didn't have the best track record of choosing the technology.
He didn't
go on the water coasters.
With the
limbs. That worked out really well.
Yes.
But yeah, no, he even
that wasn't
like
music related.
Music related.
When most people were picking between like BlackBerry and iPhone, right? Like when that was the hot decision to make, I was all team BlackBerry. Dad was on a Windows phone.
Dad
he also was very committed to the Palm Pilot.
We bought those for directors one year.
Palm Pilot.
He was all excited about it. He's like, let's order Palm Pilots for all the directors. I'm like, why? He's like, they're so cool. I'm like, they're really not, Will.
Dad
like, they're not
loved
cool.
a Palm Pilot. Loved a Palm Pilot. And then Palm made a phone.
Yep.
And Dad was like, this is the height of technology.
So we did this. Like, we bought these Palm Pilots for all the directors. I think two of them used them.
We got like, Palm Pilots one year for Christmas.
I'm sorry.
We were super pumped. We loved them.
Really?
We loved them. Yes.
I break out my stylus and play really tiny solitaire.
Yeah. And doodle. That's about all you could do on it as a child was play solitaire and doodle.
I made myself use it, but everybody's like, how do we use this? Like, well, I'm like, okay.
Give it to Leah and Lauren. There you go.
We loved it.
Yep. So
it became antiquated after about a year.
Did you like with the Palm Pilot? Did you share the information with other people, or was it like
no?
It was just on yours.
It was just on yours.
I mean, you had to like sync dock it to like.
There was a way you could do email, but like I don't know. I think you had to have like an adapter to like plug into something because like Wi-Fi like wasn't a thing.
You did. And so we did not do that. So it was another one. I was like,
you had to like sync up with it.
Yeah. Oh, geez.
That makes, yeah. That's crazy.
An electronic.
I loved
diary.
It. Though. There's that little like,
yes.
Yeah, basically.
That's what we used it for. Like a little diary, solitaire. But,
like the ones we had like a little like thing that like flipped back. So it literally was like a little cover, notepad.
And there was a stylus that popped out. And like the one we got, you could change out the faceplates on it.
Change the color. Mine was purple.
I had leopard.
Isn't there a story about you and a phone that, and you put lots of rhinestones or something on it?
I had a palm phone.
I have like a small Smithsonian.
Well, here. I had a
this
palm.
Is a good
90s
story.
Technology.
I had a palm phone because I wanted the T-Mobile Sidekick.
Yeah.
I really wanted a T-Mobile Sidekick, but you could only get it if you had T-Mobile, and T-Mobile didn't work here. Mm-hmm. So I elected to get a palm phone because I was like, this is really cool. My dad thinks it's cool. So
how old
I
were
think
you?
It's cool. Like 16, 17. Okay. Does that sound right?
Yeah.
Anyway.
And dad had only steered us wrong. Most of the time.
Yeah. So, you know, we blindly followed him anyway. Yep. But anyway, one Christmas break, I got grounded. Shocker.
She was often grounded.
I was often grounded. Anyway, so I was grounded over Christmas break and I had nothing to do. So I was watching TV and I decided to bedazzle the back of my cell phone.
Nice.
I know it's a palm phone. There's a lot of surface area on the back of that phone to cover. So I bedazzled the entire thing. And I did it with glue, too, because I wanted to make sure they stayed on.
The first time you did it with those, like, sticky things, and then they fell off.
And they fell off. Yeah. So then I did it again with glue.
Glued.
But what I forgot to think about as I was doing it was that the palm phone frequently would freeze, and the only way to unfreeze it would be to take the battery out and then put it back in. So the first time my phone froze, I went...
She's making a shocked / blank face. Like,
I can't open the battery door.
Sabrina, you watch way too much TikTok.
So I had to start chiseling off.
Did you get regrounded?
No, I had to start chiseling off rhinestones so I could get.
Oh, didn't I get that phone after?
You did.
With like some rhinestones on it.
I had chipped most of them off by that point, but there were like a few spots of glue still on the back.
For the record, like I was totally the child who was like, I don't care if it works, like if it functions, just I'll take it.
I loved having the coolest new cell phone.
Yeah, and like,
and I frequently
I frequently
killed cell phones. Not on purpose.
Like, I just,
but
even
I like
picking
them
a car.
Toilets.
Like, Lauren had to like pick her car.
I like
exactly.
dropped
I was
them
like,
and they broke. I lost one.
Something that gets
it's
me from one place to another.
Phones.
Yeah. Now I'm great with phones, but yeah, no. There for a while, I had a horrible track record. I kept breaking them, dropping them.
The technology was not quite there.
Leah dropped hers a couple times during the stamp ceremony today.
Oh my gosh! Yeah. I'm wearing slicky pants, and this jacket that I'm wearing has really tiny pockets. They're slippery pants.
Slickery.
And so like. I think I put it in my pants pocket once and it fell out. And I was like,
everybody looks over.
And then I stick it in a different pocket.
It was pretty loud.
And it does it again.
I to say. Yeah, it's like, ooh.
Look at Leah Cook trying to make a statement during the stand.
Like 10 minutes later, here.
Well, and I think it happened again. Like both during while. Well, my grandmother was speaking.
Oh. It was. Like at least one of them was.
Yeah. She was like, Nell noticed.
Nell tracked it.
It would have been during someone else's.
Oh,
oh my gosh.
That was clever. Funny.
We digress. Love iPod Day, everyone.
iPod Day. Oh, I also want to call out the October 23rd is Event Organizers Day. So
Shout
out to Lauren and Amanda.
Thank you. We appreciate it.
October 24th is Bologna Day.
Bologna Day.
That makes me think of Sabrina.
Yeah, we're skip that day.
Wear bologna pink that day.
Bologna pink.
Gross.
October 25th is World Pasta Day.
I will
Greasy
celebrate
food
that.
Day.
I will celebrate that.
And Sourest Day.
I might.
Leah might celebrate that.
I put that down because I will be celebrating.
I just don't know that I want to celebrate the sour with the rest of it. Because I mean, greasy pasta, that can be a thing. Or like greasy chicken with some pasta. I mean, like,
yeah,
that's
you
a
can,
meal.
You can get some something
you can
greasy
have a sour
with some
dessert.
Pasta.
Yeah.
Like lemon pie or something. Mm,
yeah.
Yeah.
But no, that's not sour.
It's not sour enough.
Once you add sugar to it, it negates the sour and it's just sweet. I have a thing about lemon flavored desserts. Anyway.
Man, touched a nerve there.
No.
October 26th is Howl at the Moon Day. I just need to call that one out for our full moon stuff. And,
six days after the full moon.
I figured October. It was a legend reference.
Oh, yes. That's the one.
That is.
That's the thing.
I like that.
That's why I did that.
I thought I was talking about the piano bar in Louisville.
Yes.
I also thought of that first, too.
October 26th is also Pumpkin Day.
Okay.
And we have pumpkin. If you haven't seen it on our website, we have stencils to do your pumpkin card.
Hey.
Oh, yeah.
Do like kitty and stuff. Yep. I'll put a link to that in the blog.
Oh, absolutely. Cute. October 29th is Internet Day and Cat Day.
It's every day.
Is it Internet Day every day?
I know. Yep. I don't understand. Maybe it's like you need to like get off of the internet to appreciate.
Say with the exception of the other day, whenever Instagram, Facebook,
it might as well have been the whole internet.
That's
all the internet's good for these days.
It's celebrating the day that Al Gore invented it.
Yep.
The Al Gore rhythm.
Oh. Ba-dum-bum.
No. Oh, we stole it from a TV show, if that makes you feel
any
better.
We sure did. But whenever they said that, we went, oh, that makes so much sense.
That's awesome.
I know that's not right, but it should be.
Yeah. It's funny.
It is now.
It feels right.
October 30th is Checklist Day, Candy Corn Day, and Haunted Refrigerator Night.
What?
Haunted Refrigerator Night.
The instructions for how to celebrate this are to don a face mask and like gloves and get those disgusting things out of your freezer that you should have gotten rid of like 3 years ago.
I don't keep stuff in my freezer that long.
Okay.
No, this doesn't apply to me.
No, definitely not.
But I will thoroughly
always
celebrate.
Have something expiring in my fridge. Oh. So
I will thoroughly celebrate Checklist Day.
Me too. I'm all about that.
I love checklists.
So just
does that go with your like office supplies thing?
Yeah. No.
Checklists and
on your phone.
Office supplies.
So just a quick poll. Who likes candy corn?
Just go me. Into notes.
I love a candy little corn.
Bit. I like my peanuts.
I love notes.
Oh my
I hate
gosh.
Candy corn.
Candy
corn. Let's all get on the candy corn train at the moment.
No.
Meh.
Go around the table. No.
No.
Meh.
Yeast.
With peanuts.
Meh.
I can do like a handful. Like after that, yeah. I'm good.
And then
I'm
they come
set.
Out with like those candy pumpkins and it's like just double no. up on yeah. the sugar. Like,
that's how the like Thanksgiving feast things that are upsetting.
No. I like the kettle corn that we have right now that's got the candy corn
yes.
in it.
Yes. No. I haven't gotten it yet.
I've heard about it.
You can mix candy corn into some things and it works.
Yeah. No. Peanut butter.
Yeah.
No. I saw a meme.
Peanut butter always goes with
seriously. Make a little spoon and put some candy corns on it.
A little spoon in your purse.
Or just eat the peanut butter.
Eat the peanut butter. That's where I'm at, Lauren. You don't eat candy corn.
All right, wait, really fast. I know we're further down the rabbit hole. Anyway, are you guys aware they make squeeze peanut butter now?
Yes.
What?
It's weird. It and is. Honestly, possibly more difficult than jarred peanut butter.
I'm a crunchy, so I don't get that smooth.
Is this like a go-gurt type of thing?
But I have to say that high school me probably would have just carried around the squeeze peanut butter and just squeezed it straight into my mouth.
I love peanut butter.
Skip the spoon.
Probably would have been better than carrying around a licked off spoon in your purse.
Listen, we are in a post-COVID world. During COVID world. That was pre-COVID. We didn't.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess even for pre-COVID, that's a little gross.
I had a paper towel.
And you didn't share your spoon.
No, there was no sharing. It was just mine. And it was in a special pocket of my bag.
Did you have that spoon washed every day, or was it the same spoon all the time?
Oh, no. I had a different spoon every day.
Okay.
Well, that's way better. Thanks for that clarification.
I thought it was necessary.
But I mean,
because it would have been gross otherwise.
I used it multiple times throughout one day.
I mean, a girl's got to eat.
Yeah.
But like I said, I would wrap it in a paper towel in between uses.
For some reason, that doesn't make me mad.
Me neither. As long as you clean it every day, you're
okay.
It's a fresh spoon every day.
That's all right, then. That's good.
I'm not sure if I believe the fresh spoon every day just based on your high school reputation.
So does your purse always smell like peanut butter?
Oh, I mean, I haven't carried that for years. It was in high school, and it would be like in my school bag.
So when you get home, did your dog like really want to like go through your backpack?
That's why I think I did have to like empty it out every day because Lyco was aggressive about food
and
bags.
Food and backpack, gum, any gum.
Our dog loves gum.
Back, you know, like in the height of the early aughts. My dog destroyed a Coach purse trying to get to one Hershey Kiss. Oh, I was livid.
Also, that little sugar fiend did get into our like formal dining room one day where we had a big old bag of Hershey's Kisses.
Yep.
I mean, like a 5 pound bag. Like it was big.
I remember that.
I tried to die.
He threw up a lot.
Chocolate and Lyca were totally fine. The big issue with the
foil.
Hershey Kisses was the foil and the flag.
Foil coming out of
honestly,
lots
I'm
of
like,
ends.
Poor thing. Yeah.
Yes.
Ooh.
I remember Will telling me that
yes.
story. That
they're like
day.
Little like pieces of paper.
And
then like,
that was how mom figured
barf.
Out what it was yeah. the little flags.
And foil.
I mean, who doesn't have that? And, you know, like, that's not normal.
Also, the color was very interesting on that one.
Okay.
Welcome to the Holiday World Podcast, where we describe dog puke.
Alrighty, October 31st is Magic Day and Caramel Apple Day.
Okay. It's not just Halloween.
Also, it's Halloween.
Oh, yeah, that.
That's the obvious one.
Well, what you gonna do? Congratulations. You've stamped your way to the end of another episode.
Or Matt Bloomhearted your way.
Yeah. I like
Bloomhearted your way to the end of another episode. Please join us in 2 weeks during your next commute, cleaning session, etc. for our next episode, Season 3, Episode 21, the one with Thanksgiving in a box. Thank you to all our behind-the-scenes pod squad, Stephen, Josh, and Sabrina. I meant to write something clever, but I ran out of time. And thanks to all of you for continuing to listen and interact.
It worked. We laughed.
Yeah. I literally just wrote, say nice things. Y'all know I appreciate you. Yeah.
Good enough.
I say it in other ways.
Good enough.
Thanks to all of you for continuing to listen and interact. If you're looking for ways to support Holiday World and Ho-Wo-Po, be sure to subscribe and tell all your theme park loving friends and rate us if you have that option on your platform.
This has been season 3
if you don't
of
have
the official Holiday World podcast.
Buy a new one.
Well, we want to hear your feedback and would love to hear our listeners' voices instead of our own. So please call us at 812-937-4401, then dial 808-1-PSD's long but informative instructions. Thank you to all the listeners we hear from regularly.
As we celebrate 75 years of
family fun. Share your feedback with us at podcast@holidayworld.com or reach out to us on social media, but especially Twitter, using the hashtag HoWoPo.
In some families, they hand down things like antique bird cages.
Thanks?
In others, a long-forgotten accordion? But for the past 75 years at Holiday World and Splash and Safari, we've passed down the love of family fun in the form of roller coasters, water rides, and unlimited smiles.
Awesome! Let's go now!
Get tickets at holidayworld.com.
Free soft drinks! Free parking! Free
Share your feedback with us at podcast@holidayworld.com or reach out to us on social media, but especially Twitter, using the hashtag
HoWoPo.
Oh, that was beautiful.
That was like sing-songy.